Hello, I'm Marion Stevens from the Sexual and Reproductive Justice Coalition in South Africa. The Sexual and Reproductive Justice Coalition focuses on five areas: safe abortion, sex work decrim, queer health, comprehensive sexuality education, and contraception. And currently we have about 170 people that have signed on to our statement of intent. We're at the Human Rights Council because even though we have a progressive legal framework in South Africa on a range of issues, from abortion to contraception, the right to reproductive health, our law and policy, comprehensive sexuality education, guarantees around equality and non-discrimination against sexual orientation, we still need to hold our government accountable in terms of implementation, in terms of the human rights of all persons in South Africa. And also it's a possibility to engage with other civil society movements in the region and internationally, and to grow global solidarity. So currently we have enormous challenges in relation to implementation. We're not implementing comprehensive sexuality education. There's a kind of range of skill in relation to who can implement and who can really provide sexuality education in schools and also in clinic settings. Not all health providers are trained adequately to provide the correct and appropriate information. Abortion services are really, really on the back foot. 9.5% of our maternal mortality in 2018 is still from unsafe abortion, and that's a huge injustice. It's a huge women's rights and human rights issue that we really need traction on. South Africa is often regarded as being a leader in relation to sexual and reproductive health on the continent. And what is concerning is that we really don't deserve that position anymore, because we're really not standing out in relation to our leadership with our current health system, our current position in relation to marginalized folks, whether migrants or refugees, sex workers and LGBT persons. What concerns me is in spaces like this, where you've got the coalition of African lesbians who've had their status taken away from them, it disturbs me that South Africa is silent on these issues and is not actually standing up for our guarantees in our constitution with a body that's representing African lesbians.